Hello. In this video, we'll be building custom APIs over Google Cloud's Vertex AI service. First, we'll create a conceptual diagram for what we're attempting to achieve, and then we'll jump into the code. The Vertex AI suite carries a wide variety of powerful AI models. However, sometimes we want to create a custom interface for these models, introducing our own business logic and perhaps even custom algorithms. This is particularly crucial when talking about things like generative AI. Google's flagship Palm AI model, for example, is included in Vertex AI, allowing us to incorporate both more traditional, use case-based AI and generalizable LLM capabilities into our APIs. Today, we'll focus mainly on the fundamentals with Cloud Functions as our serverless approach to the API. Although people often use more advanced API platforms like PG on top of their APIs, we'll treat that as optional for this tutorial. We'll mainly focus on Cloud Functions and Vertex AI, but we'll also discuss some important security concepts, specifically identity and access management, to ensure our APIs have a strong security foundation. Now, imagine we wanted to build an API on top of Vertex AI's generative AI capabilities. Firstly, we would need to go to the Vertex AI service and enable all the recommended APIs. After they're enabled, we can explore the generative AI studio and review the large language model capabilities. Suppose we wanted to create an API that generates draft job descriptions for our company. As part of this experience, we want to make it easy for people. No prompt engineering, no Google Cloud authentication, and no code. Instead, they should merely be able to supply the job title to a custom API. Let's craft a blueprint for the associated LLM prompt. Perhaps we want this job title to be dynamic and customizable via our API. We may want to do much more sophisticated templatization, ML engineering, or Vertex service integration, but this gives us a simple example for the demonstration. Ready to peek at what our model turns out? Assessing the outcome, it seems fairly impressive. The result is laced with remote-first culture elements and serves up a standard job description that ropes in the contact details we keyed in, plus references our in-house use of Google Cloud. Next, we want to fast-track the creation of our bespoke API, so we're going to morph this Python code into an API in Cloud Functions. But before that API takes shape, we need to establish a service account for it to facilitate secure communication with this Vertex AI service while avoiding any unnecessary permission grants. For example, we can give the account Vertex AI user permissions. Now let's head over to Cloud Functions. Typically, you'd want an API like this to be an open book, accessible to everyone, allowing unauthenticated access. However, these public APIs deserve other carefully crafted security controls, which we'll address shortly. We'll mostly use the default settings for the runtime, build, and security, except for the service account, which we'll switch to the one we created earlier, our trusted job description service account. Let's now get our hands dirty and create a Python-based cloud function, bringing in that promising Vertex AI code from earlier. In the first iteration, we're going to hard code the description generation. Our reward? The response text from our model prediction. A pretty solid start, right? To make things a bit cleaner, we'll rename the entry point. We're retaining some of the starter code for copy-pasting into our next iterations in this API story. Right now, we're simply doing a simple test to start. The later code will never run since we're always returning the response text before it. Before the grand deployment, we need to install the Vertex AI SDK. We'll use the latest version and not specify constraints, but consider specifying a specific version in your own work, similar to the functions framework specification. The time has arrived. Let's deploy this, but only briefly, since this is an unsecured endpoint. Hitting the endpoint, we encounter an error, but worry not, let's dive into the logs to find the culprit. It seems we stumbled upon an unexpected keyword argument, candidate count. Peeking at our source code, it seems we've overspecified our parameters. The easiest fix? Remove the problem parameter. This hiccup probably snuck in because our Python SDK version is different from the one used in the Generative AI Studio's example code. That's a minor bump. A quick edit and we're back on track. All right, it's time for take two. Will we hit an error this time? Let's dive in and see. Apparently not. We get this beautiful job description, a satisfying sight. So it's now time to buckle up and add some security by checking for an API token. We'll work through the request headers and get that API token validated. The API key header must match a certain value. You should concoct a more secure API key or possibly integrate into a separate system that dishes out these API keys. Our beloved Flask framework lays the groundwork for the cloud functions here, so we have a myriad of ways to bolster the security of the API. If an API key is not provided or turns out invalid, we'll return a 401 error. If you're thinking about extensive security layers for this Cloud Functions API, you could place a PG in front of the whole thing, have it handle the complex API security, metering, policy controls, and even maybe monetization. After deploying our function, hitting the refresh button should probably toss a 401 error our way, thanks to the missing authentication header. But what happens if we knock on this API door with a curl command and a valid API key? Let's find out. Using our old friend, the Cloud Shell, let's fire off the command right in the browser. And there's our response, our crafted job description in Markdown. Our journey is shaping up nicely, but we still need some final pieces to perfect our API, namely adding the templatization to this job description. We'll get the job title from the body of the API request and specifically a title key within JSON serialized data. To mirror that change in our Cloud Shell, we're tweaking our request to include some JSON data. We simply tell the API that we're sending JSON data and provide the job title string. As before, we have the notomatic.com email address, the remote first location description, and the mention of Google Cloud Tech. It's all there. You can find the main.py file, the requirements.txt file, and the diagram file in the video description for your reuse. Thanks for sticking around, and as always, please enjoy responsibly.